Yo, Katie, Willie, Charlie, Adam. What's going on, y'all? I'm just getting set up on Facebook. Larry Jett, my tall dreadlock friend. Oh, God. Yeah, sorry guys. I just haven't had the time to do these, man. Like with the festival and then like right after the festival, we were just like up to New England. And then like last week I was just fucking dead. I just didn't have any energy. Ashley, there's a 0% chance I'm going to be at the Dirty Head show in Baltimore. But I think Little Stranger's gonna be there, so, you know, good check out the homies for sure. I gotta, like, the thing with doing these is every time I do it, I gotta fucking relearn how to do it. Oh, fuck, I put Happy Tuesday, didn't I? It's Happy Wednesday. Ugh. What's going on, everybody? Woo! All right. 6:28, 23. All right. Okay, I think we're good. Yeah, you know, I had a bunch of friends. Ashley had a bunch of friends playing Reggae Rise Up, you know, so I wanted to go support and check it out. I don't know the guys in the Dirty Heads, though. I just don't really have any interest in doing that. Really, the biggest reason that I, you know, I'm a big, I really appreciate what Vaughn's doing with putting Reggae Rise Up in Maryland. I think it's like a really important thing for our region. So I just wanted to go support and just be, you know, support what's going on there. Like, I want to see that festival succeed, whether we're playing or not. So I'm making it a point of going every year, you know, as long as I'm in town and I can. All right, I think I got this. Yeah. Ashley, I'm pretty certain we will. Yeah. I'm gonna just position my Liquid Death like this. Give me money, Liquid Death. Give me money. I love this shit. I was 16, full of dreams and calm, completely dedicated to the act of getting some up on a plan in my head. Devious in nature, shooting fish in the barrel, using dynamite to make sure the plant succeeds. We had a big ass bag of weed. Trip to the liquor store, took care of everything we need. A bulletproof plan for the night, it was in store. An empty house is an opportunity you can't ignore. Hey, yeah, yeah. Rookie mistake, but it seemed a good idea at the time. Negative outcome never even came across my mind. Just to ignore the advice that had been given to me. Chance I would do it all again, you best believe. I put one foot in front of the other as I walk away from mistakes I made. In a corner reminiscent of all your bad decisions, they are the most fun to make. I put one foot in front of the other as I walk away from mistakes I made. In a corner reminiscent of all your bad decisions, they are the most fun to make. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Alright, Aubrey. I've been feeling like a victim, crying over a broken system, wishing I could trade my cards in for a new hand. Money's tight, but time is a commodity. A little bad luck across the line of poverty. My car's dying, my debts are compounding. Swimming the line of treading water and drowning, but hey, it's all going to be fine. I pull worries out my mind. I always must remind myself the struggle is divine. Society draws lines, but they're not how I'm defined. Relax and give it time. It's all going to be fine. Na 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 na. Truth is, I'm prone to depression, but a life spent coping has taught me a lesson. Happiness can't be bought or given despite what is missing. It's a life worth living. A billion cells all working together as one. Create the warmth you feel when you step into the sun. Our existence is a complete phenomenon. Whatever you stress and pills in comparison. Live a life following where your heart leads you. Not mimic what you raise, displayed on social media. Fuck the values society feeds you. There's no right or wrong, just whatever completes you. And hey, it's all going to be fine. My pool worries out my mind. I always must remind myself the struggle is divine. Society draws lines, but then I hope I'm defined. Relax and give it time. It's all going to be fine. Na 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 na. Alright, happy Wednesday, everybody. Sorry I haven't done one of these in a while. I've just been busy. We put on a festival. This feels like a lifetime ago at this point, but it was a very magical weekend. It was a week for me. It was just incredible. You know, everyone who was there, I appreciate you coming out and supporting. It was our best year yet. And yeah, it was great. Zach, yeah, I purposefully did that. I always see people asking me to see my guitar, so I'm trying to position my computer better so you can see the guitar more. So, but yeah, you know, like we had the festival, and then the next week we were right back out and did 5 days in New England. Those shows were great. New York City was fucking underwhelming, as expected. I think we're done going to New York City, guys. Like, it just doesn't work for us. And evidently, like, I was saying that and I was catching shit. I do not consider Long Island New York City. Like, we'll go to Long Island. We have great shows in Long Island. But we just, New York City for us is just painful. It sucks to get there. We can't get people to come out. Everywhere else in New York State rules, but it's just, I don't know. Yeah, you know, we were home for like 2 days, and then we were right back out, so I just couldn't do a stream. And then, you know, last week I was just fried, but here we are. I just updated. We have a whole bunch of tour dates, guys. We're doing a fall tour with the Expendables, and we're hitting the whole country. So you should come out. Oh, Jay, you want that new shit? You want that new? So despite that line, Jay, I'm gonna call this. I think I'm gonna call it acceptance in F. Kind of like optimism in F sharp and loneliness in A flat. I ripped that naming songs like that off of the Avery Brothers. They have a song called Paranoia in B major, and I just think it's a really cool way to name songs. Can you guys hear me all right? I feel like I'm a little further away from the microphone than normal, but I think it should be working. This is a new one. I may never play on NPR, and I'm learning to accept that the dreams I had at 26 would only feed my ego. I don't need to impress anyone besides fans that come to shows. The t-shirts that they buy are how I feed my kids. So let's talk about priorities. I wear all my principles like jewelry. It ain't about the stage, it's what you sing upon it. Honesty is paramount, whether limerick or sonnet. So I may never headline amps, I may not ever play them, but that's okay with me. Cause I'm in every goddamn word I say. Every word. And I'm making a living, and I love what I'm giving people, and I'm breaking a cycle of self-loathing. Drinking to escape with every day. I just wanna write songs like John Prine, chronicle the working class, a field reporter stating facts. But when your whole life is spent out on the road, all you know is touring. The irony of living out a dream. Musicians are blue collar, economically speaking, so I hope people still relate to the struggles I'm repeating. After all, we're just bags of meat trying to feed our families in a manner that allows us to maintain our pride. Every breath I take is spiteful. All these bastards make my eyes roll when I have to listen to their self-indulgent bullshit. Cause I write what I know about, and when I'm mad, I fucking shout it. These songs are my identity, they're more than a commodity. So maybe I will name this song Brandon fucking Hardesty. And the respect it deserves. Cause I'm making a living, I love what I'm giving people, and I'm breaking a cycle of self-loathing and drinking to escape. Glad y'all like that. I got like a whole... Last year was fucked up for me, guys, like on the business end of all this shit. If you've seen a show, I give a little speech before I play, like that or Underdog or whatever. But it was just a fucked up kind of period for me, man, where I had to wrap my head around certain truths, uncomfortable truths. And for me, writing songs is very cathartic. You know, a lot of times I'll write a song because I got a good catchy idea for it. You know, it's going to make a good catchy reggae song. And then other times I write a song because I'm just so overwhelmed with emotion that that's how I get that shit out. So I got about 10, I got a lot of songs that I wrote. I got a lot of really pissed off, angry songs that I wrote about just, you know, going through this shit. I think they're good. I think that's some of my best shit. It's not the shit that's going to make me money, but I mean, it's good music. As long as I'm playing new shit, I wrote this song a while ago and then I didn't really do anything with it, and then I remembered it. And we, you know, we're finishing up all these like songs, that like half finished songs. And I just want to, I'm going back in to record this one next month. Dalton, I got the work on this acoustic record that I got coming out this in a couple months. Love over drama, nah. Fuck. I should probably play it up here. I'm still figuring out the key I'm gonna do this in. Over drama, nugs over bottles, dreams over settling, scars over models, lyrics over everything, my foot is on the throttle, we can get it in and I work out the rest tomorrow. Work out the rest tomorrow. A wise man knows that there ain't no point wasting his time on things he can't control. But a young man thinks ain't a man alive that understands the burden he holds. So he drinks and he smokes and he curses at Jesus. Swears that he'll thrive but thinks no one believes it. He'll feel alone making it through the unknown until he discovers we are all lost to sea. Life's too short to play the victim, sometimes you're caught in the rain. And love's too sweet to suck on hate, it ain't easy but it's worth the pain. Humility is a vitamin that can shed your entitlement, so you can see that every day's a goddamn blessing. And it's never too late, I said it's never too late, I said it's never too late to live. Love over drama, nugs over bottles, dreams over settling, scars over models, lyrics over everything, my foot is on the throttle, we can get it in and out, work out the rest tomorrow. Work out the rest tomorrow. A proud man thinks that he's strong enough to shoulder the whole burden alone. An old man knows that his family that turns a house into a home. So he loves unconditionally, looking past misery, finding for ties so he burns unrelentingly. The deck is stacked but he's immune to attacks because he's backed by all the love that he found. Life ain't fair and people suck, disappointment is a taste you'll learn. Work with fire and test your luck, but ain't no one gonna outrun the burn. When you open your heart, become the sum of the parts, the world around becomes a little less cold. And the night is so dark and you're surrounded by sharks, but family always guides you home. Love over drama, nugs over bottles, dreams over settling, scars over models, lyrics over everything, my foot is on the throttle, we can get it in and I work out the rest tomorrow. Yeah. Oh, that's some new shit. I didn't know what I wanted to do with it, and I had it produced kind of in a weird way. I don't know. It's more of a like reggae, weird reggae way, but I think I kind of want to just make it like a hip hop song, honestly. But Either way, I'm going in the studio. That's going to be like a late entry on this record we're making. This record of B-sides, essentially. I feel fucked up saying B-sides because now this shit's all coming together. Everything is gas on there. Like, I sound really good. I just feel good about everything, you know? So that's going to be sometime in 2024. The cool thing, too, is, like, the way that's going to be, like, I want to get it. The reason I'm recording it is I want to try to get a feature on it. So it's, like, at the end of that second verse, you know, it's got that darkness to it. It's kind of like, it's going to be kind of like all in stride. You know, I'm just going to sing you this thing. Disappointment is a day you learn. Work with fire and test your luck, but ain't no one gonna outrun the burn. When you open your heart, become the sum of the parts. The world around becomes a little less cold. Though the night is still dark, you're surrounded by sharks. Family always guides you home. There's gonna be a feature right here, yeah. I'm gonna take this minor song and put in a major modulation, and it's gonna sound really fucking cool. Really fucking cool, yeah, yeah. Anyways, I'm excited about it. I love making music, man. It's like the only fucking thing I'm good at. That and Diablo 2 or Diablo 4. I've been all in on Diablo 4, guys. I got that shit like a week ago. And you know, I'm not bragging or nothing, but I'm a level 27 barbarian at this point. In fact, I think that's exactly what I'm gonna do as soon as I finish the stream. Just murdering fucking demons. The thing is, here's the thing. I'm calling all this stuff B-sides because it's just like, at this point, it's just old shit that I'm not excited about. I wrote like 20, 30 songs last winter that I'm really fucking excited about, but I gotta get all this other shit recorded, and it's recorded. I gotta finish tracking it and get it mixed so that I can confidently start recording all this new shit in December. Guys, there's a lot of new music coming from your boys. Lots of it. So, what do I got going on? Tomorrow, I'm playing at Middleton Tavern in Annapolis. I'm playing acoustic. I was going to be playing with my bar band, but the drummer of my bar band had a family emergency come up, so I'm just going to be playing it acoustic. So, 8 to 11, no cover. You should come through. Next Monday, in Ocean City, I'm playing an acoustic gig at Riptide from 1 to 4. And then on Wednesday, I want to say Wednesday. It's July 5th. I'm pretty sure it's Wednesday. But July 5th, we are, Bumpin' Uglies is doing our annual Rager at Secrets. Oh, and this Saturday, too, we're playing a weed festival, guys. We're playing a weed festival in Western Maryland. Because it's the day that weed becomes recreationally legal in fucking Maryland, which is gonna literally change nothing in my life because I don't know. The legality of pot has never affected any decision that I've made. I am excited though. Being a reggae band, we get a lot of work playing weed festivals. It's just a thing. I have theories on this. One of my main theories being that it's such a cash-oriented business that you got all these motherfuckers with cash that they can't put in the bank looking for shit to do with it. So they end up booking reggae bands and having weed festivals. And, you know, we've gone to Colorado to do them. We've gone to California to do them. We've gone to Washington and Oregon to do them. But Maryland having legal pot means hopefully there's going to be a lot more weed festivals out here booking us for fucking shit. So I'm excited about that because I'm in the business of taking people's money. So. You wish. Yeah, it'll be a lot of fun on Saturday. Y'all should come through. Mad vinyl update. Guys, it is, we approved the press. It's like, I think they actually just got shipped. Like, Mad Vinyl should be dropping in the next week or two, I want to say. Justin, the acoustics I'm playing. I'm playing tomorrow. I'm playing at Middleton Tavern in Annapolis. Monday I'm playing Riptide in Ocean City. Something in the orange, I can do that. I gotta remember how to do it though. Okay. KP! It'll be fine by dust light, I'm telling you, baby. These things eat at your bones and drive your young mind crazy. But when you place your head between my collar and jaw, I don't know much, but there's no weight at all. And I'm damned if I do, and I'm damned if I don't. When I say I miss you, I know that you won't. But I miss you in the morning when I see the sun. Something in the orange tells me we're not done. To you, I'm just a man. To me, you're all I am. Where the hell am I supposed to go? I poison myself against something in the orange. It tells me you're never coming home. I need to hear you say you've been waiting all night. There's orange dancing in your eyes from all the light. And your voice only trembles when you try to speak. Take me back to us dancing, this wood used to creep. To you, I'm just a man. To me, you're all I am. Where the hell am I supposed to go? I poison myself again. Something in the orange tells me you're never coming home. And if you leave today, I'll just stare at the way orange touches all things around. The grass, trees, and dew, how I just see you. Please turn your headlights around. Oh, please turn your headlights around. Yeehaw. Yee motherfucking haw. I saw someone say something about Youngstown. Ohio. Ohio's Ohio, man. Ohio fucks with Bumpin' Uglies, and Bumpin' Uglies we have, and we continue to fuck with Ohio. And we got a big show this summer at the Westside Bowl in Youngstown. It's coming up in like a couple weeks. Last time we were there, that show sold out. This one, I think it's right around half sold. I think it's going to be a ripper. It's going to be a wicked pisser. And I'd suggest coming out. There's a pretty poorly kept secret that we're going to be headlining a festival at Nelson Ledges in October. It's the first weekend of October. We can't really announce it till after other shit plays out. I think really we're waiting for Youngstown, so I didn't say that if anyone asked, but it's happening. KP, are you guys out right now? KP is my friend that does merch for Kyle Smith. She's commenting in the stream. I know you guys are out somewhere in the fucking universe. I just dropped an acoustic song, the first single from this acoustic album. The next one's gonna be coming up in a couple weeks. It's called Spinning Plates. I've been playing it a lot. People always ask about it, so if you're about to have it, I'm gonna play it for y'all. Till I shake, I lift weights until I ache. I work my fingers to the bones. Too much time inside my phone. Sometimes it feels like spinning plates. Lonely in a crowded room. I don't know, so I assume. People don't like what they see, so they all sneer and talk about me. The laughing stock of the saloon. I get lost inside my head, thinking about the things I have said, things I know I cannot change. But as the sun sets in the west, I hold this weight upon my chest. Drink coffee till I shake. Smile real big, sometimes it's fake. I don't talk, I just scream. I'm always cooking up a scheme to score a bigger piece of cake. I get lost inside my head, thinking about the things I have said, things I know I cannot change. As the sun sets in the west, hold this weight upon my chest. I get coffee till I shake. I'm on gas, ain't got no brakes. There's always something on my mind, because I overbook my time. Sometimes it feels like spinning plates. Medium rare, I'll take that steak. Goddamn, I hope you can relate. Yeah. Bump, 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 bump. Sorry, I'm trying to figure out how to block someone on YouTube. You know you made it. they have all these jokes about, you know, like, I feel like they got all these jokes about, like, you know you've made it when this happens and did it. I don't know. Like, you just hear a bunch of different, like, or life examples, like, that determine success, and it's usually funny. And in this particular situation, I have, like, in the last 6 months, I kind of have my first stalker to an extent. It's a long story, but I've blocked this dude on every fucking piece of social media, and he just keeps popping up like a fucking a canker sore. I guess it's just something that comes with as you get more successful, shit like that happens. But it is unfortunate when people cannot read the room. Yes, Nick, exactly like that. Really not exceptional, I'm pretty average, I'ma say. My attention's always deficit, but my life resides in the grain. I rarely follow through, my intentions, they are pure. I had my heart broken, and I've broken some before. My friends are far from perfect, and they back me in this war. I may not always have a bed, but I will always have a floor. Sometimes I try to predict how the future will unfold. Then I realize I don't care, it will be far more fun to be old. Oh, oh, these hallucinations, they're whiskey and dope. For an answer that needs no proof, so I play the game, though I hate all the roles, and I've got nothing, I've got nothing to lose. My own inadequacies, they consume me, I cannot break free. Mother always told me to believe, so I just breathe and wait and see. There is always someone cooler, there is always someone better. Always gonna be a cat that makes a little bit more cheddar. That's okay with me, that's the way it is. One day I will be dead, all this shit will be relative. Because a boy is born, goes into a man. Dreams are stepped on by anyone who can. I'm showing anyone my back can't. Fuck the naysayers, sticking to my plan. These hallucinations, they're whiskey and dope, and I'm looking for an answer that needs no proof. So I ate all the roads, and I've got nothing, I've got nothing to lose, yeah. These hallucinations, they are whiskey in the. For answers that need no proof, and I will plead again. Though I heed all the rules, I got nothing to lose, yeah, nothing to lose. I got nothing to lose, nothing, nothing, nothing. I got nothing to lose, yeah, nothing to lose. I got nothing to lose, nothing. nothing, nothing. I got nothing to lose. Yeah, yeah. All right. I think I've earned myself a few dungeons in Diablo 4, which is what I'm going to go do. Bumpin' Uglies, we're at the Maryland Legalization Festival on Saturday. We're at Secrets on July 5th. We're in Youngstown in a few weeks. I don't know the date. We got a whole bunch of fucking dates, guys. A whole bunch of tour dates. Hit our calendar. And we'll see you at a show. And new song, Underdog, is out. Spinning Plates coming out soon. Full acoustic record. It's a whole bunch of shit. We've been busy. We're very busy boys. All right. I don't know if I'm going to do a stream next week. Because I'm going to be at the ocean with my family. And it's July 4th on the Tuesday, so... I just don't know. I don't know what's happening. All right, bye.